Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here, taking a look at another new feature in Photoshop CS6 13.1, which is available right now to Creative Cloud members. For those of you that use Actions in Photoshop, you are going to love this feature. Actions are a wonderful tool that helps you automate certain tasks in Photoshop. But like me, you've all run into instances where the action fails to complete because either your document or one of your layers differs from the initial recording. For example, when you're recording an action for the first time, if your main layer was the background layer and you made a change to it, Photoshop takes note of that. So if you go back to play your action on a document where the layer is called layer 0 instead of background, the action may fail depending on the steps that it takes. Or what if you're running a batch action and only want to focus on landscape images from that set? Something like that would usually require scripting, which most users aren't familiar with. Well, now in Photoshop CS6 13.1, we have a new tool at our disposal, Conditional Actions. Let me show you how this works. So here on the right, I have my Actions panel open, which you can activate under the Window menu if you don't see it. For this example, let's say you're working on a project that requires a large white border around your photos, some of which you may have already opened and saved. Some may be the background layer, while some may not be. And as you're wanting to automatically apply this effect to all of your photos, creating an action sounds like the best idea. But like I mentioned earlier, if some of the layers are the background layer and some of the layers are layer 0, you're going to run into some issues. Now right now the image is the background layer, and playing back this action results in an error. And even if I continue the process, I don't get the result that I'm looking for. So to solve this, you're now able to create a conditional action to determine which action should be run. The action that converts the background layer into an editable layer, or the action that already contains an editable layer. Creating a new action just like you would normally, you now have the option of inserting a conditional action from the menu at the top right of this panel, where you're going to be presented with simple if-then-else options. In the if dropdown, you can tell Photoshop to check if the document is landscape, square, RGB, or if the layer is background or pixel. Let's choose the background option. So now we have the if set. If the layer is the background, then we need to tell Photoshop what to do. So let's choose the action that deals with the background layer. And then in the else dropdown, we can choose the action that deals with the pixel layer. Now once you have the condition set up, press OK and then stop your action. This action is only going to be the conditional action. So now, no matter if your image is the background layer or an editable layer, playing the conditional action will always give you the result that you're after. And trust me, when you're running this action on hundreds of images, not running into an error is going to be fantastic. And this is just one example of how conditional actions can help your workflow. Imagine being able to determine if your photo is landscape or portrait so you can apply your watermark in the exact position that you're looking for. Those of you who use Actions are going to love this. So if you're currently subscribed to the Creative Cloud, download this update now, dive into these new features, and if you want to check out more Photoshop tutorials, check me out on ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Take care.